Here with Chris Powell.
Okay, guys, got some snacks here. Let's try not to eat them all in the first half. Come on, Richmond!
It's eighth place Everton hosting AFC Richmond in 18th and staring relegation in the face. The last time Richmond left here with a win, the number one song in the UK was by Elvis Presley. It's now or never. And that's certainly the case for Ted Lasso's men tonight.
Mate, can I speak with you, please?
Yeah.
I want to apologize for last night. I bit your head off for no good reason, and I'm really sorry about that, and I hope you can forgive me.
Yeah, of course, yes, of course.
Thank you. Also, I read through your thoughts.
Yeah.
They're great. And I agree with every last one, but I can't say this to you.
But I need to hear it.
I agree. That's why you're going to do it.
Are you drunk?
You're giving the pregame talk. You're going to read me this.
I know.
It'll be fun.
No. Oh, my God.
All right, listen up, fellas. As of late, I feel like y'all have heard enough of my jibber-jabber, so I asked Nate the Great here to jot down a few of his thoughts and ideas about you guys and today's game. So let's focus up. All yours, Nate.
Okay.
Come on, boy, you got this, yeah, right?
You got this, Nate, it's okay.
Okay, thank you. Let's do it. Isaac.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you got this, brother, right? Yeah.
I've noticed of late. That you've been playing like a big dumb pussy.
Wow. What the fuck did you say to me, bruv?
You're more concerned about looking tough than actually being tough. There's a way to be intimidating without being physical. I hope you don't mind me saying. Sam.
Oh, no.
You're constantly getting beat on the wings. It's because you're indecisive. You second-guess more than a shitty psychic. The only African I know more imprisoned by their own thoughts is goddamn Nelson Mandela. Oh, you think that's funny, do you, Colin? You know your fancy step over bullshit. Let me ask you this. Do you wax your pubes?
What?
Did I stutter, dickhead? Do you wax your pubes, yes or no?
No.
Then why are you always trying to play like a Brazilian? Yeah?
What just happened?
Rojas.
Woo. Gross me, amigo.
Right, you say that football is life, right?
Football is life.
Yeah, well, then your defence is death. Oh. The only person I've seen lose a man more often is Carrie fucking Bradshaw.
Oh. Sex and the City.
Shh. Yeah?
Tough, but fair.
Right, Roy!
Go on. Say what you're gonna say.
Okay.
Don't read it. Say it to my face.
The great Roy Kent. You're old now. And slow. And your focus drifts. But your speed and your smarts were never what made you who you are. It's your anger. That's your superpower. That's what made you one of the best midfielders in the history of this league. But I haven't seen it on the pitch at all this season, Roy. I mean, you used to run like you were angry at the grass. And you'd kick the ball like you'd got it fucking your wife, Christ's sake. But that anger doesn't come out anymore when you play. But it's still in there. And I'm afraid of what it's going to do to you if you just keep it all for yourself.
Let's go get these fuckers.
See, told you it'd be fun.